This is the Ford Ranger Raptor. It's right over here, right at the center. It's the most badass pickup that you can buy locally. And it only sells for $1.9 million. It is the best pickup that you can buy for off-road use, but how does it perform on tarmac? Let's find out. I've done a review of the 2018 Raptor back in 2018.
Yeah, you can see the power right here.
I was able to drive it off-road, and it was the most fun that I've had on four wheels. Since the 2020 Raptor is almost exactly the same as the 2018 model, in this video, we'll focus on the Raptor's on-road performance. But first, let's do a walk around. Exterior. The exterior of the 2020 Raptor is almost unchanged compared to the 2018 and 2019 models. It still has the same wide fender flares. They have to be wide to accommodate the wider suspension and the large 285/70 R17 all-terrain tires. That's almost 33 inches in diameter. For comparison, the Wildtrak only has 30-inch tires. Overall, the Raptor is 6 inches wider than the Wildtrak, and it has a 2-inch suspension lift. It looks beefy, it looks muscular, and it looks like it can go through concrete walls. The interior of the 2020 Raptor is almost unchanged from the 2019 model. The seats are a mix of leather and Alcantara, and they have Raptor badging. The dashboard is leather covered. The instrument cluster of the Raptor is different from the Wildtrak. The Raptor has an analog speedometer and tachometer, while the Wildtrak only has an analog speedometer. I named the Ranger Raptor the best pickup of 2019. And until now, no other manufacturer has really released a direct competitor to it. The Raptor isn't just a regular Ranger with aftermarket visual upgrades. It has a different suspension. It has longer suspension arms at the front. Overall, the track is wider by about 6 inches compared to the Wildtrak. It has coil springs at the back instead of leaf springs. It has Fox shock absorbers all around. Its chassis has been reinforced to handle abuse. It has a 2.3mm steel skid plate. It has lighter 17-inch wheels. It has larger brakes at the front. The front rotor is larger by 9.5mm. The ride height is higher by 2 inches. And it has longer suspension travel. When I test drove the Raptor off-road, we launched it several feet in the air, and the suspension never bottomed out. There are so many changes to the Raptor that it's pretty impressive that Ford is selling it for less than $2 million.
So these bumps, about 25 centimeters high, so that's taller than that center island outside the sidewalk. This is taller than that. But with this Raptor, it just feels like pillows, man. There, you felt it?
Mm-hmm.
I left it on for you. It'll go on again when we go inside. Then the only guy you can see your tire and the ramp are the spotters, so we have to rely on them. Left. Slowly. damage him now. That's 650 millimeters of water, but this car can do 850. Let go your brake. Totally let go. Oh, there, now you got to feel it. Baby style, but we got to feel it. Okay, U turn to the right. Okay, it's the handling course. He didn't get us. Okay, full stop. There, you just follow it. You know, just follow the slalom. We're going like that. You can see the tire tracks. Go there now. These corners are bigger, so you can go faster. Someone in the back undid their seat.
While Ford is marketing the Ranger Raptor as an off-road vehicle, it also has advantages on the road. Its softer suspension at the back provides a more comfortable ride. It's probably the most comfortable pickup in its segment. Its large tires go over obstacles with ease. The turning radius is actually tighter than the Wild Track because of the wider track of the Raptor. Power out of the 2-liter 4-cylinder bi-turbo engine is pretty good. It puts out 200 horsepower and 500 newton meters of torque, which is the highest in its class, but probably not what you would expect from a high-performance truck. I'd argue though that higher horsepower doesn't necessarily translate to higher performance. Besides, the 500 newton meters of torque is almost the same as what you would get on the V6 EcoBoost. Also, it is a lot more fuel efficient than the V6 EcoBoost. It can do 0 to 100 kph in 10.5 seconds, which is okay for a truck of this size. It is faster than most pickups in this segment, but don't expect to win a drag race against the Civic RS Turbo. While it's more comfortable than most pickups, its performance only really shines off-road. It's meant to drive through mud, rocks, to do jumps, etc. For those things, your 0 to 100 kph time is irrelevant, and 200 horsepower is more than enough, especially if you have 500 newton meters of torque. So on the road, it's not quite high performance, just good performance. But off-road, nothing else comes close to touching it. One thing to note though is that because of the softer suspension at the back, its load carrying capacity is actually less than the Wild Track. Curiously, the Ranger Raptor lacks some of the finer amenities of the Wild Track, like adaptive cruise control, autonomous braking, and automated parking. Perhaps it is to cut costs, or maybe to differentiate it from the Wild Track, which is designed for city use. Anyway, if you're a hardened off-road enthusiast, you'd probably be embarrassed to use automated parking anyway. But it still has lane keeping assist and lane departure warning. It has an 8-inch infotainment screen with Sync 3. It has automatic LED headlamps with daytime running lights. It has cruise control, front and rear parking sensors, a reverse camera with active guidelines, dual zone climate control, power adjustable seats, and 6 airbags. Even if you don't see yourself going off-road in the near future, it is nice to know that you have the equipment to do so. And it looks the part. From an aesthetic point of view, it also stands out. It is bigger and more aggressive looking than any other pickup in the segment. Most people modify their trucks anyway. If you're thinking of buying a truck, and spending money to modify the suspension, the wheels, and the tires just by the Raptor, and you'd look more aggressive than most lifted trucks out there. And best of all, you'd have the performance to back the looks. If you need to carry a lot of payload though, greater than 760 kilograms, then the Wildtrak is probably the better pickup for you. Other than that, the Ranger Raptor is superior to all other trucks in this price segment in every way.